Education, Director of Education, there she is. Thank you, Jennifer, for being here with us as well. So the show will run, there's no intermission, so we're gonna run, it runs just a little over an hour. If you have a cell phone, please go ahead and turn it off, even silencing it, or maybe put it in airplane mode or something like that. It's good. If in the event that you need to use the restroom, and try to hold it in between, hold it the whole time if you have to, but if you really gotta go, you can go in between pieces. There's a sort of blue light transition that happens in between pieces, so if you need to scoot out, you can do that, okay? Otherwise, enjoy the show. We'll get started in just a couple of seconds. Thanks.
Thank you.
Normal ever find out?
I found out!
Only because I wanted you to.
I can't believe this!
How does it feel to get straight A's?
Like I'm looking at someone else's report card! That's how it feels!
I was going to give you a couple of B's, but then I thought, what the heck? Let's live a little.
They're going to find out about this.
Never.
Yes, they will, because I'm going right down to the office and telling them.
I don't think you're going to do that.
What makes you so sure?
Scenario, your house last night. Linda, come in here. Your mother and I want to talk to you about your report card. Nervously, you walk into the den. Head held low, sweat beads starting to form on your forehead, knowing that the highest mark you earned was a C, and that was in band. You become shocked to see your family, beaming with pride. We are so proud of you, we knew you could do it. The hugs, the praise, and let me guess, money, a trip, maybe even a shopping spree at the mall? All of this because of a few strokes on the keyboard from yours truly. No way will you give all of that up.
You're out of your mind.
Very much in, thank you.
But why? That's what I can't understand. Why did you do it?
Because I wanted to ask you out next weekend.
You wanted to ask me out?
On a date. You may have low grades, but I'm sure you know what a date is.
You broke into the computer room because you wanted to ask me out.
I didn't break in. I have a key.
And you thought by fixing my report card, I didn't want to go out with you?
You now owe me.
Owe you?
It's a matter of logic. It's like a computer game. It merely lowers the risk of failure.
I can't believe this. It just doesn't work like that.
It always has before.
You've done this before?
4 times. And those girls were all appreciative. They were glad.
Well, I'm different.
Come on. You can't tell me you didn't love seeing all those high grades. And now that you see how talented I am, don't I look a lot better to you?
Gerald, let me explain something to you. I don't date guys because of what they do for me. I date guys because I want to be with them.
So now you want to be with me, right?
No! As a matter of fact, I want to turn you in for the slime ball that you are!
I'll deny everything.
I'm sure you would.
Linda, if you go down to the office, then your parents will know your real grades.
They already do. I told them there was a mistake on my report card, like maybe the computer burped or something.
Computers don't burp.
Well, they bought it. And they were pretty disappointed with the truth. I think it made my real grades sound even worse.
That's your own fault.
My fault?
You can have good grades for the rest of the year if you want. And that's not all. How about airline tickets? A credit line at the store of your choice? Free phone calls? You name it. And me and my little computer can create it.
You are one sick puppy.
You know, I didn't enter your attitude into the equation. I really thought I had you figured out.
Gerald, you don't even have yourself figured out.
So does this mean you aren't gonna go out with me?
We become like sheep. Even though the world is falling apart right in front of our eyes, we sit in front of the TV or computer screen and pretend that everything is all right.
You watch more TV than anybody I know.
Well, maybe you're right.
Well, what are you going to do about it?
Maybe I'll just sit on top of my chair, right here, right now, and protest the silence.
Protest the silence?
By screaming out loud.
But what good is that going to do?
It would let people know that I care.
The only thing that's gonna let people know is that you're insane.
Well, I'm gonna do it.
When?
Soon.
Well, let me know before you do so that I can get away from you.
It's time for this caterpillar to shed her cocoon.
Your scream won't change the world, Gina. It's just gonna make people laugh at you.
They laugh at Einstein, too.
Only when he's screamed out loud in the library.
A movement of many starts with one voice.
I know you didn't make that up.
No, but I saw in a box of herb tea, and it really got me thinking.
In your case, thinking is a dangerous thing.
This is no game. This is my destiny. Wake up, people! Rage against the silence! Rage against injustice! The movement has begun.
The only movement I see is the librarian coming your way.
Look up.
Up.
Okay. Ramona, we're 13. We're not kids. Drew didn't come today. Or Natalie. Or Madoka. Or Lynn. I could have had a date today, Mona. Sam Stevens asked me to go to the movies, and I really wanted to go. Ramona, look at me.
Remember the burrito?
I know about the burrito. We're not kids anymore.
We were, though. It was the first day of winter. We were 7 years old.
Ramona, I know the story. I was there.
Eyes up, I'm telling the tale. Okay, it was the first day of winter. We were 7 years old.
It was Natalie's birthday sleepover party.
And we ran outside to catch the first snowflake on the first snowfall of the first day of winter.
And when you catch the first snowflake of the first snowfall on the first day of winter,
any wish you make will come true.
And we stood in Natalie's backyard.
Ramona, Jenny, Drew, Madoka, Lynn, and Natalie.
Best friends till the end.
With our heads thrown back, arms open wide, and tongues out.
And we all made the same wish on the first snowflake.
And what did we wish for?
Burritos.
And what did we have for dinner?
Burritos.
And did we know we were having burritos?
It could have been a coincidence.
And did we know we were having burritos?
No.
And did we not make a pact? A double spit, high hand, shoulder slap, double hit pact to come together on the first day of winter to get the first snowflake.
Mona, I don't spit anymore. It's gross.
Non-believers, all of you, we caught the first snowflake on the first day of winter, and that wish came true. We wished for burritos. Burritos. We could have had money, fame, guys, health, happiness. It happened once again. Just be one time thing.
Yeah. Did you just add guys to the list?
I know it wasn't a burrito coincidence. It was the world's colliding to create a magical wish euphoria. First day of winter, the first snowflake, the first snowfall. It can't just happen once. It can't.
Do you want a boyfriend, Ramona?
What?
Well, I've been hearing this first snowflake wish euphoria speech for years now. Money, fame, health, happiness, and now, guys?
So what? Maybe I'm changing things up.
Ramona St. Pierre!
Oh, shut up!
You're looking for a date!
What? So, don't be ridiculous. It's nothing.
I was looking at a prom dress.
Ramona St. Pierre!
Shut up!
You're a girl! You want to go to prom!
Don't be ridiculous. Of course I'm a girl.
This is a happy day!
I'm not talking about this anymore.
Do you like mermaid or A-line?
Eyes up.
Do you know what color?
No talking.
I think Taylor Levine likes you.
Remember the burrito or go away. I can do this on my own if I have to.
I'm not going anywhere. Burrito forever! Viva burrito!
Well, that's excessive.
Silver satin empire with a beaded bodice and a bow in the back, if you're asking. And Taylor Levine is very cute.
I didn't say anything.
Good.
Silver would look good on you.
I thought you weren't saying
anything. I can talk to Taylor in English if you want.
Burrito, Jenny, burrito.
Ramona, look!
No talking.
Look at the clouds, at the sky. That's a snow sky.
What?
The first snowflake of the first snowfall on the first day of winter. This is it!
Holy cow!
I'm wishing for you, Ramona!
I need all the help I can get. Heads back, tongue out.
Leo, Leo, Leo!
To to the feet. I can't control myself. I'm a dancing fool.
Stop it. You look like a spat. Come on, to the dance floor. I'm not dancing by myself, and I'm certainly not dancing with you.
We don't have to. We can each ask a girl to dance with us.
You tried that?
No, I've tried that.
Four times.
And you rejected
a four times.
Yeah, well, at least I tried.
Maybe I'm realistic. I know my limitations.
The way I see it, it's their loss. I know that once I get out of this place and go to college, things will be different. Girls will find me a sexy because I'm a smart.
Stop dancing in your chair.
I know the only reason why you don't want to ask anyone to dance. Two words. Jennifer Burns.
No,
you have known her since you were a little kid. The two of you have been neighbors since you were little kids. And hey, everybody knows you fall in love with the girl next door.
You don't even talk about her.
Of course not. She's into popularity and wealth. Let's just say that in the chess game of social prominency, you, my friend, are a game of checkers.
She's not as shallow as you think.
Oh, man, you are so in love with her that even when you walk past her in the hall, she doesn't even acknowledge you.
She does?
Not in the East Hall,
where it counts.
Look, I'm sick of this. Besides, this dance is lame. I'm out of here.
Hold on.
It's about to get better.
Jennifer.
With ever popular Randy Allen, textbook dream couple. That's barfable, isn't it?
Well, maybe she likes the guy. Come on, if you do an internet search under jerk, his name pops up first.
Well, you seem happier than we are.
You know what? I say you go for it. Ask her to dance. What's the worst she could say? No?
Yes. That is the only thing she would say.
You don't know until you try.
Yes, I do know.
The two of you have been friends since you were little kids. Just make this a friendly dance. She's coming over your way. Come on. Come on.
She doesn't want me. She's just thirsty.
Oh, come on. She's playing hard to get.
She's winning the game.
I'm sorry that I have to do this, but it's for your own good.
Hey, Jen! Why not come dance with your old buddy Michael here?
You can do that?
With a snap of my fingers. Not that snapping my fingers is really necessary, but it'll make it seem official.
You mean to say that Jennifer Burns, all of a sudden, will be in love with me?
Completely.
For how long?
As long as you want.
What do I have to do for that?
Nothing.
Come on, there has to be some kind of catch.
None.
Somehow this just doesn't seem right.
Neither did all those years you've had to suffer, watching from the sidelines as other guys went out with her. This is your time now, Michael. You deserve it.
I don't know.
What do you mean? She is, and she will be in love with you from this moment on.
That's the problem. From this moment on.
What? You want this retroactive? That'll be a tough one.
No, it's not that. Jennifer was never in love with me. She's got so much going for her. She's smart, pretty, and a great personality.
And now she's all yours.
Not this way.
What, you want her blonde? I can arrange that.
No, it's not the hair. What about her life? You snap your fingers and she falls in love with me, but I know that's not what she wants. It's what I want, but it wouldn't be real. She'd be in this weird kind of zombie trance and no longer be the Jennifer I care so much about. And I do care about her.
Look, you can't have it both ways, kid. Think about yourself. What do you care as long as you get what you want out of the deal?
You know, something like this would be good for Kurt. He'd take you up on the offer in a minute. He thinks I have low self-esteem, but it's not that. I just realized that there's a lot of people like me who fall in love with someone that just doesn't love them back. I'm not alone. Maybe someday someone will fall in love with me, and I won't have feelings for them. Would I want to be forced to love them? No way. This isn't a fairy tale. This is real life. And because I love Jennifer, I'm not going to screw up her life by forcing her to love me back. Maybe someday she'll change how she feels about me, but it'll have to be her decision.
Hey, it's your call, but I've got to tell you, I fairy godmothered hundreds of people through history, and nobody's ever done this before.
You mean to say I'm the first one you've granted a wish to?
Please, how do you think Shakespeare learned to write? Or Marilyn Monroe became a movie star? Or Bill Gates got all his ideas? They sure didn't turn me down. I guess there's a first for everything.
So you'll change Jennifer back?
Yeah, whatever.
You could do one little thing for me.
Name it.
No more slow songs tonight. Makes everyone who's here without a date even more depressed.
Done.
Thanks.
You know, I'm not giving up on you. I was assigned to be your fairy godmother for the duration of your life.
How long is that?
Not sure, and I wouldn't tell you if I knew, but I will tell you this. One of these days, I'll come back around when I think you need something. I'll stay away from the love thing, but you may want good grades or a job promotion or even help finding a lost set of car keys. Just do me a favor. Try not to have so much integrity. It really throws me off.
Johnny Depp.
I wasn't expecting anybody, actually.
Must be tough being so perfect all the time.
And it must be tough being so ticked off at the world all the time.
Hey, see you around.
Hope not.
Ugh.
Oh gosh, it's stuck.
Oh, nothing gets past you, does it?
You're trapped down here. What are we gonna do?
Unless you got a blowtorch in there somewhere, we're screwed.
I'm looking for my cell phone.
Forget it. You're not gonna get any reception down here.
Found it.
Darn it. Did you just say darn it? What are you, 6 years old?
I don't curse. My mother says it's unladylike.
Your mother would love me.
So, you're here by yourself. Sad.
Don't patronize me. Honestly, I don't know why I came tonight. I hate these things.
Me too. It's just a popularity contest.
Exactly, but isn't that like your thing?
You'd be surprised. There's a lot you don't know about me. So what do we do now?
I guess we just wait for somebody to come by and hope we're not stuck down here all night.
Or all weekend. What's that?
Maybe it's your treasure map.
It's a love letter.
Dear Shannon, this is so sappy. I think I'm gonna vomit.
I think it's romantic.
Of course you would. I bet your Eric writes you love letters all the time.
Nope.
Is that bitterness I detect? I'm shocked.
Why?
Because everyone thinks you're the perfect couple and you guys have been dating since like birth.
Eric's a nice guy. He really is. We just don't have that much in common anymore, you know?
Go break up with him.
I'm going to, right after homecoming. Oh my gosh. I can't believe I just told you that.
Me neither.
You can't tell anybody. Eric doesn't suspect a thing. That's why I'm waiting until after homecoming to do it. If he's distracted because I broke up with him, he could lose the game, and I just couldn't live with myself if that happened. Please, Angela. Thank you so much. Has anybody ever written you a love letter?
Once, Daryl Rinder drew me a dirty picture in eighth grade. Does that count?
No, you didn't.
Yup. And let me just say, now I know why you failed anatomy.
You know, I bet if you just changed your wardrobe and wore a little less eye makeup, guys would be drooling all over you.
I don't want guys drooling over me.
Hey, there's got to be one guy you'd like to impress, right?
I'm not going to tell you.
Come on, I told you about Eric.
I have a crush on.
Come on. It's okay.
Wayne King. Okay, there, I said it.
So, do you ever, like, talk to him?
We sit next to each other in study hall. We're always joking around. He's really funny.
That's great. So why haven't you ever asked him to maybe hang out after school, go to the movies or something?
Because guys like Wayne King don't go out with girls like me.
That's not true.
Yes, it is. You of all people should know, Miss Perfect. You've always gotten everything you've ever wanted. You're with your mani-pedis and your designer clothes. Everything. You've gotten everything you've ever wanted, including guys. The rest of us were just not that lucky.
I guess I understand now why you hate me so much.
I don't hate you, Missy. Could be a real snob sometimes, but don't hate me.
It's good to know. Am I really a snob sometimes?
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. No, I'm not the easiest person in the world to be around either.
You can say that again. Gosh, this is one of the old uniforms.
No, I've always wondered what it'd be like to be a cheerleader.
Really? You should put it on.
Yeah, right.
Why not? Nobody's gonna see you. Come on, don't be chicken. Besides, This is your chance. I'd love to see you in something other than black.
Okay, I'll try it on.
This is so exciting.
Yeah, I can't believe I'm actually doing this.
I'm proud of you, Angela.
Shut up before I change my mind.
No reason to be hostile.
Hey. Are you ready?
Yes.
And what do you think?
Doesn't appeal to me.
You're my best friend in the world, Jim. If there's anybody who understands me, it's you. If there's anybody who I trust, it's you. That's why you're here. So, look out, please, for my sake.
I'm at a nice silly party. I'm about to get somewhere with a nice silly girl. And my friend Walter drags me by the arm and leads me to Central Park Lake.
It's pretty. Enjoy it.
It's 2 o'clock in the morning.
2:10. Listen, how quiet. And the Spirit of God drifted across the surface of the waters.
Look at that duck. It's asleep. It's not hanging open.
Have you ever had a dream, Jim? Something in your head, a feeling. Something you wanted, but you knew that you could never have.
Probably. But nothing comes to mind.
Something's happened to me, Jim. Something that could never happen to me has happened to me, and it's the most wonderful thing, but it's also the saddest. And nobody knows.
All right, I'll bite. What?
I'm in love.
Aw, oh, give me a break!
I am.
All right, I believe you. But did you really have to dirty my shoes and break up my neck to tell me that? So you're in love, Walter. I'm sure it seems pretty important to you, but really.
She's a mermaid, and she lives in the Central Park Lake.
In the lake?
Yes.
Well, that makes sense. If she's a mermaid, she would live in a lake. A freshwater mermaid, huh?
Don't make fun.
It's so easy. What are we doing here?
Well, I want you to see her.
Why invite your parents so the family can be here?
I've only seen her twice now. And it's always been between the times of 2 o'clock and 2:30.
What's that?
A little plastic pumpkin.
Ask a silly question. Oh, and it lights up. Very nice.
It's our signal. I turn it on, and then I call her name.
And how did you hit on the sophisticated system?
It came to me in a dream, Jim.
A dream.
Yes. Listen, it's amazing how quickly you'll be able to accept all of this once you've seen her.
I'll bet.
Sally? Sally!
What are you saying?
I'm calling her name.
Sally?
Yes.
Sally the mermaid.
Yes! You got that right. Sally!
I'm leaving.
No! Don't go! I'm a man who's in love with a mermaid. And she's in love with me. And it's the most wonderful thing, but it's also the saddest. To love somebody that you can't have, and she's a dream, too. Come on. Do you understand what I'm saying, Jimmy?
I don't know what the hell you're talking about.
Come on, just wait one more minute, please. One more minute. Sally! Sally!
There's no one out there.
She's out there. Sally! Sally, please!
No, there's no one there. Why don't you come with me? You should go home and get some sleep.
No. No!
All right.
Remember, back in the day, when nothing was impossible and we saw everything the same way and we loved each other?
I'm worried about you, Walter.
I'm fine.
No, you're not. You're not.
Sally! Why didn't you come? He was my best friend. He was my friend. Sally! Oh, God.
Walter. Walter.
You came.
Alliance. You, me, the goth kid, the girl in the wheelchair, the autistic one.
There's an autistic one?
Matthew.
Oh, I thought he was just Artie.
He's a little autistic. I'm serious. We could team up. I mean, there doesn't seem to be much competition for the role. Do you think I don't have friends? Because I do. On the internet. Some, but...
Nice shoes.
Thanks.
They're just like Jessica's. And Sarah's. And Violet's. They all have the same shoes and you're wearing them.
I genuinely like them. Also, they're cool, but...
They're terrible people.
Who?
Jessica, Sarah, Violet.
No, they're not.
Have they ever been nice to you?
Look, people just stay in their comfort zones. It's like...
You know what people say about you? They say stuff about me too, but they've got it all wrong. They think that right now is like permanent. That like right now is the biggest deal ever, but I don't think that is. The world could end at any moment.
Do you really think that?
Is it true your dad is in jail?
Is it true your parents are total crazy Christian fanatics who built a bomb shelter in their basement and filled it with cans of beans and evaporated milk in preparation for the end of the world, which they think is really soon, and they give away your life savings to charities, and every night you kneel together in your living room facing the moon like a tsunami is coming, but it never does?
I asked you first.
I asked you also.
Let's go at the same time. One, two, three, yes.
Yeah. If they think the world is ending, then why are you still in school?
Because I want to be. Now that you know everything about me, can I tell you something?
Sure, yeah.
Then I have to tell somebody, or I'm going to die.
that I'm strongly considering kissing my neighbor Robert, who has the most magnificent eyes. I have been taught that this is wrong, but I want to so bad. For the past few weeks on the weekends, I sneak out after my parents are asleep, and we meet up on the street corner, like just past 11, and then we'll go to his basement, and he makes mini pizzas, and we watch MTV. Okay, we're best friends.
Why is your dad in jail?
For killing my mom. So,
I'm sorry.
It's fine. I was like barely a person when it happened anyway. Nobody knows that but you. So,
I won't tell anyone. What was the score? Was it 9-10?
9-11.
Will that ever not mean anything anymore?
Probably not.
And that's where I met this girl, and we, you know,
Awesome. Oh, I think the movie's about to start.
This is going to be boring.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna sneak out of here before it starts.
Yeah, me too.
I mean, they can't teach me or show me anything I don't already know.
Once you hit 12, you've seen it all.
Ha ha ha!